Time to eat, everyone.
See the gar? Yeah, don't risk it then. Oh, tilapia, right under it. Ooh. Dude, I can see the fish in the net from here.
Ready? Take a shove in those.
Fired up. Look at the red tail. Oh, his head's fully out of the water.
What is going on, Cafferos? Welcome back to another video here. Today, we're going to the canal in the backyard. First, I need to feed the animals, because you know that's like an everyday routine, twice a day. Gotta feed the animals first, but then we're gonna run to the canal in the back.
My house is surrounded by this canal. It's all the way around the entire yard. Hey, buddy.
And there's a lot of fish in it. We've been casting in it lately. During quarantine, we have nothing else better to do, so my boy Logan and I have just been going out there, throwing the net.
A bunch of cast nets here. They're not big. They're like 3 to 4 foot nets. They're really, really small, but they do the job. So we have, I'll be using that one, I guess. You can throw that one. We'll each bring our own bucket. And we're gonna bring some fish back and feed. Okay, so a little story time.
There's a few bass in here that we cast netted, and we've just been throwing like little minnows in just for now. They're not gonna stay in here, but we just did it to like pretty much acclimate the pond.
You can see there's a gar down there, bass. These will not be in here.
Once again, repeat myself, I'm taking these fish out and putting them either back into the canal or into the pool pond in the backyard. We just literally put them in there because it's super fun to hand feed fish. And they're blowing up out of our hands. So we're gonna bring some baits back, hopefully get those suckers to eat on camera, and also stock the main part of this video is to stock the pond in the backyard, my pond. So before anything, I'm gonna go feed the animals while Logan makes his way over to the canal and starts cast netting, and we'll see what he gets when we get over there.
Walk around with a little baby, always. Time to eat, everyone. Goaters, they're all just vibing. Same old same, you already know the drill, Cafferos. Bam. All the animals follow me as I run. And first dibs, go for it. Sweet lady ma. Ducks, your food is on the duck side. I gotta put like a piece of wood there. What up, big girl? What up, big girl? See our little chicken friends. These guys have all been hanging out with her.
Once this quarantine thing is over, I'm gonna try to see if I can go online and maybe find Lady May a bigger pig friend that we could put with her. She just really doesn't get along with many animals. That's why she's alone. She still has, obviously, the communication through the fence with all these pigs. And also, most importantly, Donkey on the other side. I see thousands of comments, by the way. I see all your comments. Donkey is getting a new friend. I just can't really go anywhere and get any big, large animals right now. The little piglets were an exception 2 minutes from the house. But other than that, I can't really be going out of my way. Till this whole thing calms down, which hopefully it's 10 seconds from now because I'm over it, totally over it.
These things are crazy, crazy, I tell ya. Oink. There it is. There it is. They're crazy. It's so cute. You guys are destructive. Like, look what you do to this enclosure. So this enclosure is mucky because it's been raining so much. There's nothing in here, obviously. But this is the open one right next to the pigs.
Now that we finally got a big, heavy rainfall, the canals are finally filled up a little bit. They're not all like drained down to the floor, to the bottom, to the shore, to the pond ground. There's a gator?
It's been a little gator hanging out back here. A little alligator.
Okay.
Making our way downtown for real now.
So Logan's gonna be casting over there, and I'll be casting over here. But I do have to film this by myself though, so I'm just gonna like, you know. All right, so when I'm talking, these nets are small. They're really small. But watch, there you go, watch this, ready? Yay. Oh God, I caught them up too. Cafferos, we're gonna catch a lot of different species today. There is no water in this bucket. That's not a good thing. So in this cast, we just caught bluegill. That's what a bluegill looks like. And we also caught, they're so slippery and scaly, shad. Never even knew these were in here until we started cast netting back here. But we got shad and a bluegill. 4 fish, 2 shads, 2 bluegills. And we're just gonna keep on netting. The goal of this video here is to just catch as many fish as we possibly can catch and put them in the pond. Just throw them in there.
Let's see if Logan's got them here. Good cast net, except for I literally just threw there. But you know what, a lot of times it really doesn't matter. Nice little bluegill, 2 bluegills. Yep.
Logan's gonna be cameraman one time while I get a nice cast net in there. These bugs are gnarly, huh?
Oh yeah. Got a couple laying some eggs in my ear.
They're laying eggs in your ear?
Yeah.
Yeah. Me too.
Ooh.
Dude, those type pristine. Of casts get them every time, I promise you. You'd be surprised. I didn't catch a single fish.
Remember what I just said like 3 seconds ago?
Ooh, those type pristine. Of casts get them every time, I promise you. Let me try to get to the other side. See those lily pads? All the way over there.
Jeez. That was perfect.
Oh, holy moly, is this one tiny. Look at the little fella.
It's for good luck.
Got one. Come with me, Cabarrus. We gotta move locations because we ain't catching anything. So for those of you who don't stay updated on all my videos, first of all, if you're not subscribed, make sure you subscribe down below. Click the subscribe button. Also click the bell so you're notified every time I upload.
See the gar? Yeah, don't risk it then. Oh, tilapia right under it. Tilapia jetting.
Flies, bugs.
We are sight fishing at this point. Like this, it's so shallow here because we haven't gotten much rain. We did get one heavy rainfall, which filled this up a bit. But this is literally my backyard. Like I never film back here. Whoa. Hi, buddy. You're a big dog. Oh, you're the one that never stopped barking in my videos. Just throw it ahead of him. Okay, so ignore the dogs barking in the background. They usually don't stop. But there's, if you look closely, a bluegill swimming along the bottom right there. Right there. Dude, oh, he took off. Gone. Look at that mark. You got him? There was two of them, right?
Got out.
Oh, we got him. That is so sick. So we're literally sight fishing these things. This is a sunfish, actually. How sick is that? We literally sight casted that fish from the bank. Big one, too. That's not a small fish, I mean, for what we've been catching out here, at least.
We actually came out here the other day and cast netted, and we caught bass, we caught Mayan cichlids, we caught a bunch of different things. We put them all into here, right here, which is the pond. This is the duck pond from the backside. Never showed it from this angle.
But look how cool this is. The water comes, like, all the way up to here. You can see, if you look really, really closely, tilapia mouths all have arrows pointing to them. It's tilapia. You see him moving over there? Isn't that crazy? That's where all the tilapia hang out right there.
Oh my God. Dude, that's ridiculous. I just threw the net on the shallow part. Oh, that boy wrecked him. He wrecked him.
Dude, I could see the fish in the net from here. Dude, come on, dog, please, homie. So what do we got here? This is the Mayan cichlid. So this is what a Mayan cichlid looks like. This is actually an invasive species, but there's just so many at this point, you know. That's a Mayan cichlid. Super cool fish, though. This is a bluegill. That's a straight-up bluegill. The one we caught earlier was like some sort of sunfish, but that's a straight-up bluegill. Bluegill, and that sunfish thing just jumped out of me.
Gotta love when you get the perfect lighting for a thumbnail. Did the Cafaro face?
Bruh.
Did it all. I'm gonna try to take a cast net in my pond. Oh my God, I see them all. They're all up there.
Oh my God.
Dude, that's ridiculous. I just threw the net on the shallow part that I was just filming a little bit ago. And that's how many little tiny tilapia I just pulled off that. So if you look closely, Logan, make sure you get a good focus on that. You see some of these smaller tilapia, they're still alive, they just get stuck in the net. And for those of you who do cast net, know exactly what I'm talking about. It's a pain in the butt. So let me show you how to get fish out without killing them. The best way is, what you're gonna do is, there was like 100 of these stuck like this. Just shake the net. See? Oh, okay. Literally all of them came out besides one. So that's super easy. You grab like the side of a net and shake it hard like this, and they'll just kind of pop out. It's what stops them from going through the net. What you want to do is just kind of grab around their face like this, like that, and just pull this fin down and let the net just roll over it. Some of them, they'll literally be stuck. You can't get them out and they will die. But other than that, you can save a lot of your fish as bait, or if you're eating them, whatever you're casting for, you can save a lot of it like that.
It's super high, but I do have some of the fish that we've cast netted so far, like shad, and by the way, inside this pond, there's a lot of shad now. There's a lot of shad now because we've been stocking it. Logan's throwing some bigger ones in that you saw him cast net, but we're just stocking this pond with pretty much everything. It's kind of cool. Like, look at that shad swim away. How funny would it be if the bass just came up and wrecked it? We did put bass in here, but yeah, just put the rest in here. Some shad, there's some bluegill.
go. Pond stocking at its finest. It looks so cool from here because I never film from this angle. But remember, when I first got this house, there was not a single fish in this pond. I dug this pond myself with an excavator. I have videos, pictures, I mean everything, you name it. YouTube videos on when this pond got dug. We put like 25 tilapia in it. I don't even know how much, but there was a video on putting those few tilapia in here. Now there's thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands. So I film these little videos like this, putting the first Mayan cichlid, the first bass, the first everything in here so that later on, once we catch the bass and they're 6 pounds and we catch the Mayan cichlids babies, it shows that they're literally reproducing in my own dug pond. That's why I love filming stocking pond videos.
We breed our own fish out here. Right, dude?
All right, so I got my net. We just got one bucket of water. Logan's got his net. We're going down where he just caught those. We're gonna really do some damage now. We ain't playing around. I'm just gonna set the camera up. We're just gonna do a time lapse on throwing that net a bunch of times and see how many fish we can get.
The fish probably love hiding in those palm trees and stuff, you know? There's some nice water plants right here.
Oh, God, here we go again. Dude, listen, I'm gonna have a serious talk with this dog. Home slice, home slice, come here, buddy.
Listen, bro. Listen, homie, you know how many videos I've been filming and you're out here just, ow, ow, ow. Dude, come on, be mature. Serious conversation here. Please.
And he shook his head no. Okay, dude, I tried.
Oh, it took off, dude. And there's a bass in there. Look at the wakes.
You know, it's crazy because way back when I first started YouTube, years and years ago, this canal, these canals, is what me and Luke fish. You remember my buddy Luke? He lives out here. He's lived out here since then. I never planned on getting a house out here. This was the last place I'd ever expect to live. But yeah, it's kind of cool because these are the canals that we always walked around with nets, fishing poles, and just literally like little jits just walking down the canal fishing. And now like I live on it. So it just reflects every time I come out here and just walk this canal. I walked this exact canal 5 years ago with Luke and cast netted tilapia just for the fun of it. Not even to stock a pond or feed anything, just for the fun of it.
Yeah, dude, let's just put the camera down and sauce them up. You agree?
Yeah, if we can.
All right, pick up the camera in just a little bit. I caught a lunker, boys and girls. There's a fish swimming right there too. But I gotta get him into the water. There he goes. I sight fished him in shallow water just like this. I saw him and I threw the net and landed right on him. I'm gonna bring this back
in the duck pond and then put the rest of the bait in the front pond and see if we can get some feeding on video. If you have not done so already, hit that like button for me. Drop a like if you want to see more videos out on the canal here. I believe this is the fourth bass. I could be wrong. Fourth bass, I think. It's going into the duck pond back here.
Pretty fish though. Wow. See you later, buddy. Whoop. Into a pond. That's massive, about 8 feet deep in the middle at least, and stocked with bait. That thing's gonna be huge. That bass is gonna grow like crazy. The rest of you, wait, let's feel. Yeah, the rest of you are going into the front pond. Hello, little duckies. This pond looks big right now when it's full. It's only fair that I get one of these shad and put it in the pool pond and watch some big predatory fish destroy. Ready? Take a shove in those. Golly. Just like that, fellas, gone. Woo-hoo-wee. They're fired up now. They're fired up. Look at the red tail. Oh, his head's fully out of the water.
That's awesome, but this is super, super cool because they're baby bass and they blow up.
Oh, okay. Couldn't really see it, but he ate it. Gone. Throw another one. Watch this. Bam. How cool is that?
How many more? Like two?
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
There you have it, folks. Thank you so much for watching. Once again, please do hit that subscribe button down below. Follow me on Instagram at Paul Cafaro. You'll see a heck of a lot more and a lot of previews, things I post on Instagram before I put them on YouTube. New animals, yada, yada, yada. At Paul Cafaro, that is. And yeah, positive comment goes out to Lai, I believe is how you pronounce it. Great video, Paul, keep it up. Thank you. And if you want to win a positive comment shout out and be in one of these videos, all you gotta do is drop a like on the end. See you in the next one. If you didn't get that, if you want to win a positive comment shout out, all you gotta do is drop a positive comment down in the comments down below. Thank you.